What's up, guys? Jim with unityofnoise.com here, and I just wanted to do a quick tutorial on how to set up multi-track routing for the new Ugritone Riot Drums plugin. Now, I could totally be saying that wrong, and I'm not exactly sure how to say it because I haven't really heard anyone pronounce it, so if I'm saying it wrong, please don't murder me. So, let's just get right into it. So, first thing we're going to do is create a MIDI track. We're going to drop the Riot Drums plugin on this MIDI track. Now, Riot Drums, these things sound pretty great. This isn't really mixed or anything. This is just, you know, everything's at zero. But if you're looking for a good analog drum sound that's really inexpensive, this is a great plugin. It's only $5 right now. If you look around online, I'm sure you can find it. Just search Riot Drums, $5. So you've got a mixer window. This mixer window will take you through every single piece of the kit, the different microphones that are on the kit, panning the pieces of the kit left and right. It's pretty rad, pretty simple. So we get into the routing. The routing gives you three options. The first option is basically everything coming right out of this plugin on channel one. A lot of people are going to use it this way. It's the simple way to do it. It's really quickly. As you can see, if I play my little MIDI clip here that goes through every instrument in the plugin, you'll just see it all coming out of this one channel. So that's the simple way to do it. No big deal. There is a second way to do it, which is a simple mixing route, which is six stereo outs. Now, if you look at this matrix, you've got kick, snare, toms, all the way through China and ride. That's 12 total channels of drums, okay? And if you look at each one, they're labeled as which channel each one's going to come out on. Starting with the kick on one, going through the drums up to the hi-hat at six. But at that point in time, once you hit the hi-hat because you're hitting the cymbals, everything is going to come out on channel six. And that's fine. That's another very simple way of doing it. It's somewhat similar to just miking all the drums and then having like one or two overheads to catch all the cymbals in one microphone. Definitely an easy way to do it. We're going to do the most complicated way to do it, which is actually very, very simple to do as well, but it'll give us a full 12 channels out, every single drum and every single cymbal being on its own separate channel, and will give you the most flexibility within Ableton as far as your productions are concerned. So right off the bat, what do we want to do? We want to throw in a MIDI channel, throw on the Riot Drums plugin, then you're going to go to routing, and then you're going to switch the routing to matrix below 16 stereo out. Now from here, you have to do a little bit of routing from the crash one forward. You have to change a few things. We just need to make these all keep progressing up to channel 12. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, and then I will be right back. Something I should mention here is like you can actually just click these. You don't have to use the click up and down, but you can just click these and then put in the channel that you want it to be on. So for instance, this is channel 8. This is channel 9. I was routing these wrong for a second there. I'm now fixing that. So now, as you can see, every single channel on here is routed to its own specific audio out. That means that every single channel on here is going to give us its own specific signal that we can thus then manipulate within Ableton. So at this point in time, everything's done within the Riot Drums plugin. We can close out this window and go back to Ableton. Now, what we want to do is we want to add 11 more channels. And you're probably saying, why only 11 if we have 12? Well, channel 1 here where the plugin lies, that acts as channel 1. So your kick drum is going to come off of this. And when I click play on this clip, you'll see you'll hear the kick and then nothing else. Kick, even though there's other MIDI notes here. So the reason for that is because the plugin itself is coming out on channel 1 and treating this specific channel as channel 1. So now we're going to create 11 more channels to go from the snare all the way down. So this is just Command T for audio track. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Now we have channel 1, where is the Riot Drums plugin, and then channel 2 through 12. So now what we want to do is select channel 2 through 12, and we're going to change the audio from to Riot Drums. Now, if you don't have this in-out section, if you look over here on the right side of Ableton, you'll see a small little button that says I-O. That might be turned off. So just turn that on and this whole entire section will show up. This is your in-out for audio routing. So once again, just select channels 2 through 12, and for audio from, go to number 1, which is Riot Drums. That's telling every single one of these channels here to pull its audio source from the Riot Drums channel on channel 1. Now what I want to do is I want to take each one of these channels separately and make them match the numbers above. Okay, so if Riot Drums is channel 1, this is channel 2, so we want to have it come from channel 2 Riot Drums. Channel 3, channel 3 Riot Drums. Channel 4, and so on and so forth. And we're just going to do this all the way down till we get to channel 12. So now what we need to do is make sure that there's set up to bring in the plugin. So we want to turn all these channels on monitor in, and that will basically allow us to hear the signal coming in. So if I play my little routing test here, this is going to go through every single instrument, and you should see each instrument come up on its own separate channel. Super simple. So now what I like to do, because I like making sure that things are labeled correctly, I go through and I name all the channels to match whatever that channel is representing. So with the Riot Drums plugin, I would actually name this kick, and then I'll put a slash. And that's just simply so I know that the channel 1 is kick, but I also know that it's the channel that has the Riot Drums plugin on it. And then we have snare, tom 1, tom 2. Now, if you are confused about which channel you should have, you know, you should rename this to, all you got to do is just open up your Riot Drums, go back to routing, and match everything. So channel 1, bass drum. Channel 2, snare drum. Tom 1, tom 2. You can literally just look at the plugin and match what it's saying with this respective channel. Hi-hat 6, et cetera, all the way down. But that's all it is. That's all you need to do. Now you have every single one of your channels coming in on its own separate sound. And you can thus then go ahead and manipulate the sounds as you want to with each channel individually. And it gives you a lot more fun. Now a little bonus tip is grab all of these channels and group them together. This is just Command G. You're going to create a new group. I'll call this group Drums. Now you have all of your routing from all of the separate drums going down into one channel. Now what we can do, because we have all this audio coming down into this one group, we can go ahead and throw in some plugins. Like, I'm going to turn that down a little bit. Now we could throw in EQ. Maybe we can throw on some overdrive. Now, most people will throw the compressor at the end of all of this stuff, but that's just personal choice. You can get some pretty crazy sounding drums with this, some pretty cool stuff. So basically, that's it. I'm Jim from unityofnoise.com. I hope you guys have a great one. Make sure you guys like and subscribe, and I'll see you soon.